Hey, welcome to the Explainer. Today, we're diving deep and cracking the code on the .NET technical interview. By the end of this, you're going to have a solid mental model to confidently handle pretty much any question that gets thrown your way. So, let's get right into it.
So, let's kick things off with a really important question. What's the actual difference between a developer who does okay in an interview and one who absolutely nails it and gets the job? You might think it's all about having every single answer memorized, but trust me, that's not the full picture.
Here's the real secret. The thing they're actually looking for, your thought process. They want to see how you connect the dots, how you reason through a problem. So this explainer is designed to give you that exact framework for thinking.
We're going to level up through four key stages. We'll start with the absolute must-know foundations, then we'll see how to apply those concepts in real code. After that, we'll shift into an applicational mindset, and finally, we'll pull it all together with a winning strategy.
First up, foundational concepts. You can think of these as the absolute bedrock of .NET. You really have to be rock solid on this stuff, because literally everything else we're going to talk about is built right on top of it.
Let's start with the original, the OG, the .NET framework. This came out way back in 2002. And it was Microsoft's big play for building apps that ran specifically on Windows. It was this massive, complete ecosystem, you know, with the common language runtime and the framework class library, all designed to make Windows development way more powerful.
So what's the engine humming under the hood of all this? That would be the CLR, the common language runtime. It's really the heart of .NET. It's this virtual machine, this execution engine that does all the heavy lifting for you. We're talking memory management, security, and of course, garbage collection. It's what makes .NET a managed environment, and that's a huge deal.
So how does the CLR actually run your code? Well, it uses something called the just-in-time compiler, or JIT. See, when you compile C# code, it doesn't immediately become machine code. First, it turns into this intermediate language, or IL. Then, the JIT compiler steps in and translates that IL into native machine code right when the program is running. This clever two-step process is what makes .NET code so flexible.
And that brings us to a classic interview question, managed versus unmanaged code. It's simple, really. Managed code is anything that runs inside the CLR's nice, safe bubble. Unmanaged code runs outside of it, which means you're flying solo, you have to handle your own memory management. Interviewers love this question because it's a quick way to see if you grasp the fundamental value of the platform itself.
Okay, next up, another interview staple, boxing and unboxing. Boxing is when a simple value type, like an integer, gets put inside a box. It gets wrapped up into a more complex object type. And the cool part is, this happens implicitly or automatically. Unboxing is just the reverse, taking it out of the box, but you have to do that explicitly. They ask about this because it can affect performance, and it shows you understand how .NET moves data around in memory.
All right, now that we've got the foundations down, let's move on. It's time to see how all this theory actually gets put to work in real-world applications. This part is all about connecting the what to the how, the stuff you'll actually be doing day-to-day.
One of the most common patterns you'll see in ASP.NET is MVC. That stands for Model View Controller. It's a design pattern that neatly separates your application into three main parts. You have the model, which handles all your data and business rules. You have the view, which is the user interface, what the user actually sees. And then you have the controller, which acts like a traffic cop, managing user input and telling the model and view what to do.
Now let's talk about something absolutely critical in modern .NET, dependency injection lifetimes. Seriously, the choice you make here is huge. A singleton service is created just once for the entire life of the application. A scoped service is created once per client request. And a transient service, that's brand new every single time it's requested. Knowing which one to use and when is just essential for building efficient, scalable apps.
Oh yeah, this is a big one. You absolutely have to know the difference between the old school ASP.NET and the modern ASP.NET Core. The main takeaway is this. ASP.NET Core is the present and the future. It's cross-platform, which is a game changer. It runs on Windows, macOS, and Linux. Plus, it's been rebuilt from the ground up to be faster and more modular, making it perfect for today's cloud-based applications.
In web development, performance is king,
and caching is one of your most powerful tools. Any interviewer is going to expect you to know the basic types. You can use output caching to save the entire response of a page. You can use fragment caching for just a little piece of a page, like a menu, or you can use data caching to store data and save yourself from making slow, expensive trips to the database over and over again.
Okay, let's level up again. This next section is all about showing that you don't just write lines of code, you think like an architect. That means you understand the whole system, the trade-offs you have to make, and the big picture of how an application actually runs out in the wild.
In the ASP.NET core world, you're going to hear two names all the time, Kestrel and IIS. Kestrel is the default web server. It's super lightweight, cross-platform, and incredibly fast. But it doesn't have a ton of features. That's why in a production environment, you'll often see it sitting behind a more heavy-duty server like IIS, which acts as what we call a reverse proxy. It handles the incoming traffic and adds layers of security and management.
One of the coolest concepts in ASP.NET Core is the middleware pipeline. The best way to picture it is like an assembly line. When a request comes into your application, it has to pass through each piece of middleware in a specific order. Each one does something to it, checks for authentication, figures out routing, checks authorization, before it finally hits your code and a response is sent back down the line.
And a really key step in that pipeline is authentication, which is just a fancy way of saying proving a user is who they claim to be. You should definitely be familiar with the common ways to do this, from older methods like forms and Windows authentication to more modern API-focused approaches like token authentication using JWTs or JSON Web Tokens.
So we've covered the tech, the patterns, and the high-level architecture. Now it's time for the final piece of the puzzle, your strategy. This is all about how you package up everything you know and present yourself as the perfect candidate for the job.
So here's how you pull it all together. First, don't just memorize answers. Have a strategy. Always, always lean into your knowledge of modern, cross-platform .NET Core. When you're explaining a concept, don't just say what it is, explain why it's important. You know, for loose coupling, for maintainability. And most importantly, show your work. Articulate your thought process out loud. Show them how you arrived at the answer.
This quote right here really sums up everything we've talked about. Your interview is not a pop quiz. It's a performance. It's a chance to demonstrate your problem-solving skills in real time. If you can show them how you think, you will absolutely stand out from the crowd.
And one last thing, and this is so important. An interview is a two-way street. It's a conversation, not an interrogation. So when they inevitably ask if you have any questions for them, be ready. What are you going to ask about their architecture, their biggest challenges, their team culture? Asking smart questions shows you're not just looking for any job, you're looking to be a contributing member of their team.